All right, Rob, before we go, we're going to get into an NFL topic, but news just broke that Andrew Wiggins, the swingman for the Golden State Warriors, apparently he applied. He's not vaccinated, Rob. The rules, the state law, or the laws, at least in San Francisco.
Right, in San Francisco.
That, yeah, yep. That you must be vaccinated to play in games there. So as it stands right now, if he doesn't get vaccinated, he would have to miss the 41 home games for the Golden State Warriors. He applied for a religious exemption. The NBA denied it. That just broke. So now we'll have to see what Andrew Wiggins decides to do. I'll say this quickly. We're not going to stay here too long, but obviously we'll both comment. I don't know anything about Andrew Wiggins' religion. I don't know if he's devout. I don't know if he's Christian, Muslim, Buddhist, Hindu, whatever. I have no idea. But I'll say this, and I don't know if he's sincere. Like I said, I don't know if he's devout. My guess is that the NBA determined a couple things. One, that perhaps he's not devout, or maybe more importantly, the religion he claims does not have any rules against vaccination.
Right.
Maybe that's it. But I would say this. If he is devout, and if his religion does have strict rules against that, against vaccination, then I think the NBA is wrong. Because religious freedom is something that is a bedrock part of this country. And if indeed it, that is the case with him, and again, I don't know that it is, then I think that you should get an exemption for that.
Yeah,
I'll tell you quite honestly, if I had to go against some of my core, the core fundamental beliefs of my faith for whatever job, then you can fire me because I'm not bending on that. And if Andrew Wiggins is that devout, and his faith is that strong, or, you know, his religious faith dictates that you not get vaccinated, then I think he should stand firm.
I'll give you the perfect example. Sandy Koufax missed Dodger playoff yep. games because he wouldn't pitch on Rosh Hashanah and what's
Yom
the other
Kippur,
holiday?
Right?
And Yom Kippur. Those are holy holidays. He pitched for the Dodgers, and he just said, I'm not pitching, and he didn't pitch. And those, if they fell on those days,
right.
So Chris, if you have that conviction, and that's where you stand, then you could stand on that, and teams could either decide that we'll take Sandy Koufax every other day of the year, except for maybe those 2 days. You know what I mean? And you work with it.
You work in this case, rotation.
Yeah, you know what I mean? But in this right. case, with 41 home games,
right.
I don't know how that works. It just doesn't work. And I don't believe the NBA, if he had a track record, Chris, a history, right. you can't be like Johnny Come Lately. Oh, right. I joined this religion yesterday, and they say you – do you know what I mean? Like
yeah,
that's what
I
it has
exactly
to be based
you
on.
Mean.
You can't use it as a shield. If you weren't a practicing or this wasn't a part of your religion, and I'm sure you had to make a case for it and they had to hear it and they didn't feel it was substantial enough to be able to say, yes, he's granted
right.
that. So that's why I don't
I
think the NBA,
you.
Right? There's no way
yeah,
the NBA.
I mean, and again, I've never, you know, there's players you've heard about being religious. I've never heard anything one way or the other about Andrew Wiggins. And like you said, if it's something you just recently kind of
right.
gotten into, then it's just not. Then in that case, Rob, I don't blame the NBA.
No, because you know? Then everybody could say that,
right.
Chris. Right tomorrow.
Absolutely.
Oh, you know what? I'm Jehovah's Witness now as
yep.
of Saturday, and I need a
exactly
a exemption. No.
Exactly. You got it. I'm sure they probably talked to people with the Warriors, with
yep.
the Timberwolves, which was his team before that. Is this a consistent thing? Is he, you know, sincere about this? Does he practice?
Or is he trying to buck the system?
Right, right. And my guess, Rob, and this goes for Kyrie as well. Now, Kyrie, obviously, it's harder to predict what he's going to do. But my guess would be that Kyrie and Andrew Wiggins and any other player that is in this category will get vaccinated and play. That's my thought.
I agree because 90% of the league is vaccinated.
Right.
I really believe the NBA would have a different situation, Chris, if it was 90 unvaccinated and 10 vac. Do you know? Like, you would have a problem.
Yeah.
If it was that.
We will see. But that's interesting. It's something interesting to follow with the New York City and San Francisco teams in the NBA. All right, Rob, let's go to the National Football League. And the Browns are hosting Chicago this weekend. And it is the return of Odell Beckham Jr., who has not played this entire season. It's only been two games, obviously. But
and he missed it. What did he play, four games last year, Chris?
I think he played five.
Because I was ready to cash in on his touchdown number, and then he got hurt. Remember
I know. You lost shekels on that, huh?
I lost shekels. He had to get, I think it was 5.5 or 6, and he had 4, Chris, when he got hurt.
He actually played 7 games.
Okay. How many touchdowns did he have? He had 3 receiving and 1 rushing.
He had three.
Right? Because
exactly
he had like a 50-yard run, and that gave him 4 touchdowns.
3 receiving, 1 rushing. But here's what I want to throw. And look, he couldn't come back at a better time because Jarvis Landry is out. So now you slip OBJ in his position, and you still have a top-flight receiver. But I want to throw this at you, Rob. Odell Beckham Jr. was a no-doubt superstar and celebrity, right? I mean, the records he owns, Rob, are just – I had forgotten he had so many records. Look, just quickly, fastest receiver to catch one – or fastest player to reach 100 career receptions, 14 games. Fastest to reach 150 receptions, 200 receptions, 250 receptions. Fastest to reach 3,000 yards, 350,000 or 3,500 receiving yards, 4,000 receiving yards. Most games with at least 125 receiving yards in his first 3 seasons. Most receiving yards in his first 2 seasons, 2,744. Most consecutive games with at least 90 yards receiving, 9 in 2014. And finally, Rob, most consecutive games with at least 130 yards receiving and a touchdown. The dude, he did a lot in his first few years, and that's why I want to throw this at you, Rob. Is he still a star? Is Odell Beckham Jr. still a star?
Odell Beckham Jr. is still a star to me until he's healthy, he goes out to play, and he can't do it anymore. I need to see that before I say he's done, he's finished. When guys are hurt, if we get out there and he can't get separation, he's not making these plays, he's not getting 10, 12 catches and 150 yards, he's not hauling in touchdowns. Once I see him play for an extended period of time healthy, I can then say he's no longer that guy, but he's been hurt. And he was off to a decent start last year. I'm still on that star platform. I still think people look to see what this guy can do. And he's just been, his career has been derailed. So I'm not there yet. I need to see, a lot of sample time, Chris, before I can take a look and honestly say yay or nay on him. So the last time I saw him, he was still playing at a high level. So I'm going to say he's still a star.
I don't think he's a star anymore. Now, I'm not saying he won't become a star once again, but right now I would not characterize him as a star. I would characterize him as a celebrity. He's still a celebrity. As you said, he's still a guy that's going to draw eyeballs to the set that people want to see played. That's a big story because he's coming back.
In sports, so I get that's called that. A star. In sports,
no,
that's
it's
a star.
There. It's called a celebrity. A star gets it done on the field. No, a star to me. I'm not into all the celebrity. I'm not into your personality and, your how many followers you got on Twitter and Instagram and all that. I'm into production. And to me, a star produces.
See,
and
last
year he didn't produce.
But a
7
star,
games he had 23 catches.
But a star
he was
to
averaging
me,
45 yards a game.
But a star to me is still somebody who attracts attention, who people want to watch. That to me is a star. You can
so
have
it has
receivers.
Nothing to do with their ability.
No, but it's a part. Like when you talk about he's a celebrity. He's a star player. That's what you would call him. If they were writing a story about him, they would call him a star player. They would.
Well, that don't mean it's a fact. I mean, like I'm judging it by your production. And he hasn't produced.
But you can have production
lately
and not be a star. I mean, I don't think, I think there's
not, Chris, not at the highest level.
There's a combination of, yes, I get the production part, but some people do it with more flair. Some people, there's
Tim
guys
Duncan
who,
didn't do it with any flair. Was he a star?
And you know what? And he never got like the star treatment.
I know, I think, you're not going to sit here and say he wasn't a star.
No, I didn't say that, but he never got the looks or that the people felt like, oh, I got Tim Duncan's playing. I,
right,
I got to watch Tim Duncan.
He wasn't a celebrity.
No, because he didn't have the star factor. He was he
right.
produced and
he
was productive, but he wasn't a star like that. I'm talking
Wait,
about
what?
No,
he was
I'm
a
not
star. Thank God you threw in like that. I don't know
like
what that means.
What
but
I'm
that's
talking
a little.
No, what I'm talking about is I'll give you Reggie Jackson. Whether he was striking out or hitting home runs was a star. Reggie Jackson. I want to watch Reggie Jackson. That's what I mean. You could be a star, Chris, and not produce.
But Reggie Jackson produced enough.
I
at
know
a certain
that.
Point to the point that when he stopped producing because of age, he was still a star because we understood it was age. Odell Beckham Jr. is still young. Odell Beckham Jr. hasn't been in the Pro Bowl in in 4 years.
No, I get it, but I think
so
people also understand that he's been hurt.
Right. I'm not saying he won't be. I think he's still got talent. I think. I haven't seen anything, obviously, but I think he's still got the talent to maybe reemerge as a star. But right now, I mean, there's so many receivers I would name way above OBJ when you talk about the top ones in the game. And I agree. We just got different definitions. I think he's a celebrity.
I think people
I don't
will
think
want
he's
to
a
watch
star
him come back.
Football player anymore at this point. He,
see,
like I said, he could get back
play.
To it.
He's like one of those guys you want to see. And I believe people want to see what this guy's got, what he can do. He moves the needle. If he has, Chris, if he goes out this first game back and has 3 touchdowns and 150 yards, people will be like, Odell's back. Oh, my God, I got to watch him.
That'd be great.
It'll be
right.
just like that. Would you agree with that?
If, yeah, but
if
that
he has
doesn't
one,
mean he's a
one
star.
Good game, people will be like, oh wow, Odell's finally healthy.
Because he was a star. And we know, yeah, I'm with you on that. I mean, was White Chocolate Jason Williams a star?
No.
In the NBA? Well, he was must-see TV. He moved the needle.
That was only because of his skin color. I'm sorry.
Whatever. He moved in, and he actually was a pretty good player.
No, he was. I'm just kidding.
So, but he wasn't a star. But my point is he meets some of that criteria you threw out. If you're talking about just a storyline, moving the needle, people want to see him and all that. But regardless, I would love to see him get back to his old form. And he's young enough. He's only 28. So we'll see
he
what
seems
the connection.
Older than that. Wow.
Yeah, we'll see the connection between him and Baker Mayfield is. He will turn 29, Rob, on November 5th.
Okay.
But remember, last year, Baker actually played better without OBJ. So we'll see how he responds to OBJ coming back Sunday. That's going to be one of the storylines of this game.